Hello everyone, welcome to Computer Science and IT Gate Coaching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the instant notification of my free lecture.
Now see, I changed the question slightly. Here what I did, now number of A's should be in such a way that when you divide by 3, the remainder should be 0. Okay, means it should be not divisible by 3. Previously it was divisible by 2, now it should be divisible by 3. And B should be divisible by 2. So now A's remainders will be either 0, 1 or 2, because if when you divide by 3 you will get either 0, 1 or 2, and B's remainder will be, so when it is A's remainder is 0, then B's remainder will be either 0 and 1, because number of B divisible by 2. Okay, so B's remainder will be either 0 and 1. So one state you will get, that will indicate that 0, 0, that both remainder is 0. So this is for A's remainder and this is for B's remainder, and here 0, 1. Then again for 1, when A's remainder is 1, B's remainder can be 0, 1. So 1, 0, 1 state, 1, 1, 1 state. Now for this 0 and 1, 2, 0, 1 state, 2, 1, 1 state. So how many states you required here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 states you require. Okay. Because you require that many combinations. That because number of A's and B's should be either in such a way that both remainders is 0, 1 remainder 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 2, 0, 2, 1. So that's why we are getting 6 states. Because every state is going to say something. Here state is saying that A's remainder is 0, B's remainder is 0, here A's remainder is 0, B's 1, A's 0, B's. Sorry, A is 1, B is 0, like this. Okay. So what I will do, now we will construct a minimal DFF for this language. Okay. So 0, 0 is going to be the initial state. Same reason as I have told you in the previous lecture. Because initially there is nothing, epsilon. So in epsilon, number of A's is 0, number of B's is going to 0. So if you divide by 3, you are going to get remainder as 0 only. So 0, 0 is going to your initial state as well as the final state. So A's remainder, this is for B's remainder. Now if you will get A, so it was having, let us assume X number of A's and it is having B number of A's, okay, sorry, Y is number of, same reason, same way, if I will get A, okay, if I will get A, then number of A will get increased by x plus 1. X plus 1. So here x was in such a way that when you divide by 3, you are getting remainder as 0. Okay, that's why you are getting. So x mod 3 you are getting 0. Same y mod 2 you are getting as 0. But if you get increase plus 1, x plus 1 you will do, you will get remainder 1. So it will go x 1 and b's remainder will 0 only. If you again get another A, then A's remainder will now become 2, but B's remainder is going to remain same, because I am not giving B, see, I am giving only A, okay. So 1, 2, but now if I give B here, so A's remainder will remain same, but B's remainder will get increased by 1. Now if I again give B here, then B's remainder is going to become 0. Okay, because first it was having Y, then it become Y plus 1. That's why remainder. Then again if I give 1 B, Y plus 2 will become, because again B. So now it will be divisible by 2. This is what divisible, B is for 2. So you will get 0 remainder. So you will go there. A's remains same. Now for this I have given transaction for A. Now for this I need to give for A, I have given B, I have to give. So here B's remainder are 0. If I give again B, B's remainder will get increased by 1. Because B's is 0 means it is having Y only, see, Y only. So it will be 1, 1. Now 1, 0, if 1, 0 state will get B, it will go to 1, 1, because A's remainder same, B's remainder will get increased by 1. So 1, 1 I am creating here. So B. Now again, if 1, 1 get B, B's remainder will change to 0. Okay, so it will go to. Now similarly here 2 0, if I leave B, it will be 2 1 because B's remainder will get increased. So I will make here 2 1. Again B 2 0, go back. Why? Because see, B is only, I am giving here B. When I am giving B, then B's remainder will change because A's remainder is going to remain same because I am not giving A. Okay, so and B's is going to either have the remainder 0, 1. From 0 it will become 1, 1, then 0. Because when you divide, it is dividing by 2. And in case of A, it will either go 0, 1, 2, like this. Okay, now for here, you have to give A. Another for A also, you need to give a transaction. Now here A's are in such a way that you are getting remainder 2. Means first A's was X, you got 1, X plus 1, then another A, X plus 2, X plus 2 you got. Now another A if I give, then you will, the number of A's will become X plus 3. And if you divide by 3, X was divisible by 3, that's why you got remainder 0. Now 3 will also become divisible by 3, X plus, this is also divisible 0, so you will got remainder as 0. So this will become 0 and it will go there. So on getting it, it will come. Okay. Now for AB done. Now for here B done, now A. If I leave A, A's remainder will get increased by 1. Go. Here if I leave A, A's remainder will get increased by 1. From here if I give A, A's remainder from 2 it will become 0. So it will go 0 1. So state 0 1 is. So here A done, B done, A done, B done, A transaction given, B transaction given. So for every state I have given the transaction for AB. Okay. Now if we see the question, this question. Here I am counting the number of A horizontally, okay, and B is vertically. See, giving transaction of B is vertically and A horizontally. So for this kind of question that I have told you that there is third shortcut way, you just give transaction of A is horizontally and B is vertically or vice versa. Means you can even count B is horizontally. If you are counting B horizontally, then you will count A vertically. And what you will do, you will just copy that same transaction all the time. What I mean, see, now in this problem only, I will just let you know how the shortcut will work. So you know one thing, if you divide by 3, number of A by 3, you are going to get 3 states. And when you divide by number of B's by 2, you are going to get 2 states. Okay, so always for this kind of questions, you are going to get what for this 3, then for this 2, then 3 into 2, 6 states you are going to get in minimal DFA. Okay, so here in this kind of questions, what number you are going to get that in cross product, that is going to be your minimal number of states. Only for this kind of question, whenever you will do cross product, you are always going to get the minimal number of states. Now the shortcut is saying that you count A either horizontally or vertically. I will show you both. Okay. So you count either A horizontally or vertically. If you are counting A horizontally, then B vertically. If you are counting A vertically, then B. Okay. Horizontally you have to count. Now first what I will do, I will count A but horizontally. 0, 0. By getting A. 1 0. B is remainder same. This is A's remainder. This is B's remainder. Okay. Again by getting 2 0. Okay. Again by getting a 0 0. A's I counted horizontally, B vertically. 0 1. Again B 0 0. Till this you have to do. Then just copy that part and do same. State copy, transaction do this B there, then B there. Similarly, just write B here. then horizontally what I have written here, then copy that. Same, A transaction here, then A transaction here, then A transaction. So we have to copy what the transaction horizontally we have given, give. Or if number of states is there, give same. Vertically, same. So this is the shortcut. Fine. Now, here you are increasing a given transaction for A. So increase the A's limit. 0, then 1, then 2. B's limit, B's you are not increasing. So B's will remain same. Either you give the transaction like this, but this it will be same. See, here you are giving B's. Okay, so B's remainder will get increased. This is B's remainder, increased to 1. This is B's remainder, increased to 1. A's remains same. A's remains same. This is 1. Now I will count B, A vertically. Okay. So initially 0, 0. Getting A. This is A's remainder. This is B's remainder. So it will be 1, 0. Again A. Then 2, 0. A's remainder will increase. Again A. 0, 0. Go back. Now B. Then 0, 1. A's remainder same. B is 0, 1. Again B. 0, 0. A's remainder will remain same. B's will become 1, 2, 0. Now same thing, do the copy paste. So this, I will again create one state here. B there, and then B here. Okay. Again I will create one state here. Same way. B there. Horizontally I have did the copy. Vertically I have to do the transaction copy. So B, A here, then A, then A. So this I have to write. A. Okay. A. Now write the transaction either by using this or by using this. So here I am giving A transaction. So G A's remainder is going to get changed. B's remainder is going to remain same. So B's I am making same 1 1. I am increasing A. So A's remainder will get increased 0, then 1 1, then 2. Okay, like this. So here every state is indicating, see, that this state is indicating that number of A's and B's are in such a way that number of A's remainder is 1 and B's remainder is 1. Here this state is saying that number of A's remainder is 2 and B's remainder is 1. Here state is saying that A's remainder is 2 and B's remainder is 2. Now if I change the question that number of A's for this should be 2. And it should be 1. So for previously it was going to be the final state. Okay. It was going to be the final state because both were saying 0, 0. Now I am changing the condition that I am saying that number of A should be in such a way that when you divide by 3, remainder should be 2. And number of B should be in such a way that when you divide by 2, remainder should be 1. Means 2, 1. The state which is having 2, 1 is now going to be the final state. So this is not going to be the final state. Only the final state now going to change and rest is going to remain same. Okay. So here also now 2, 1 will become the final state. Because here every state is indicating the remainder. So now the remainder is, you want that A's remainder should 2 and B's remainder should 1. So depending upon the condition, the final state will only change. The final state is only going to change. But the transaction diagram, this diagram is always going to remain same, whatever you will do, same transaction you are going to get. Okay, so based on that we are going to get many questions in gate exam, and in gate exam they will generally ask you what is going to be the minimal number of states you require for. So for this kind of questions, whatever will be the means, if for this kind of questions, if you are having number of A in W mod K1 equal to, sorry, N, here I am using N, K1 means number of A, if you divide by N you get remainder K1, and number of B W mod M should be K2. So for these kind of questions, whatever will the number N and M, N into M is going to be the minimum number of states. See, you are dividing here with 3, Here you are dividing it to 3 into 2, 6. In minimal number of states, in minimal DF, you are going to get 6 states. So just by seeing the number with which these two we are dividing, you just do the multiplication of these two and you are going to get the minimal. So this question carry 2 marks and it will even not take 10 seconds. See, just by seeing the number of A mod N equal to K1, number of B mod N equal to K2. Okay, so here it was dividing with N. Here it was number of is dividing with M. So they are asking what is going to be the minimal number of states. A into M. That's all. Two number. Okay. Now give a note and write, if one automaton contain N number of states and another automaton contain M number of states, then the cross product of these two automaton contain N into M number of states. This may or may not be minimal. Okay. So this number may or may not be minimal. In this example, it is going to be minimal. Okay, so that also I have written. If the question have number of A in this string congruent K1 mod N, means when you divide number of A in this string with N, you are getting K1 as remainder, and number of B's congruent K2 mod N, when you are dividing with M, remainder is K2, then the minimum number of states in the minimal DFA. So minimal number of states in the DFA only is fine. Okay, minimal number of states in the DFA, because minimal number of states in the DFA is going to be the minimal DFA. Okay, is going to be M into N. So you are going to get M into N, where K1 and K2 are constant. K1 is going to have some value, that is from 0 to N minus 1. That remainder either it will be 0 to N minus N number, and K2 is from 0 to M minus 1. So by just seeing the numbers, now you can give the answer what is going to be the number of states you require.